He's right about that. How y'all doing tonight? Thank you, Bruce. Give it up for Bruce one more time and all the other comedians. That was funny. So Bruce is great. It's my third time back, my fourth time ever. And it's awesome. I'm glad we're here. But Bruce, I'm a little upset because I've become wildly more popular in the last month. And you obviously did not read the email my secretary sent you. First of all, I've had to sit with the common folk. Okay? I asked for 3 Fiji waters on stage, ice, 2 limes, 1 lemon, also not here. Bullshit. And what is this? Bartender, can I get a Voss? Do you have Voss? Of course you're not this fucking gamer. Sorry, I'm just a little cranky, guys. I've been getting wasted all week. Every night, just tons and tons of Grand Theft Auto. Not very good at it. I am upset though. It's been tough writing jokes because I recently went through a breakup. I think that's like you become a comedian, right, guys, and then you just lose your girl. I work with her though, so I'm better.
Oh yeah.
But I was going through a lot at the time. My grandmother just died. I just lost my job, and I didn't feel right about the breakup. I actually tried to get back together with her, So I did all these nice things. I wrote her a poem. I like went to her house. I cleaned her whole house and all these things, and it didn't work out because it's like right after we broke up, she was like, "Just kidding, I'm a whore." So I'm glad it didn't work out because relationships that are on and off, they're like Fast and the Furious movies. You know, they get strung out way too long, and the best part of them died a long time ago. So I'm just looking for that lucky lady to rebuild my Paul Walker with. Yeah, I'm just kidding. I'm not jumping back out there like it. I'm gonna wait to see the new Jumanji movie to be that disappointed again. So I told one of my buddies the Fast and the Furious joke, and I was like, "Listen, man, I won't put you out there, but it's Josh Penske." And he was like, "Dude, I've never seen any of the Fast and the Furious movies." And I was like, "The sheer statistical numbers alone should make that borderline impossible. There's just so many of them. They're like fucking Now CDs."
Now, that's what I call racing.
Hey, I should have left that. But I was like, "You never just like went to a buddy's house and just like they were watching it?" And he, with all seriousness, looked me in the face and was like, "Chris, I don't hang out with those kind of people." Right? And I'm like, that's how I describe like meth addicts. You just... Alright, so I was telling him about the breakup, and I remembered I did some pretty petty shit to the girl. You guys ever do that? You break up with a girl, you're mad and bitter, you know, if they treated you wrong, and you know, you go get that one fucking sweater from their house, you know, that you've never worn ever. But this is what I did. So when we were together, she had cards to like every grocery store, you know, Acme, Food Lion, Walgreens, and I always use the Walgreens cards. I live close by, I'm always in and out of there. And so when you don't have the card, you enter the number, you know. And after the breakup, just out of force of habit, I entered the number, right? Boom. The lady's like, "Sir, you have $3 on your Walgreens card. Would you like to use that?" I hesitated just for a second. I looked back at her with a huge smile. I was like, "I absolutely..." And in my head, I'm walking out like, "Boom, bitch. You just paid for 56% of my toilet paper." Daughter. I know she's just every night awake just fuming about it. So I have been struggling to write jokes. I was upset about it, kind of moving on from it. And so I was trying anything and everything to get back in a funny mood. Great thing. So I smoked some weed for the first time in a long time. I did a lot, you know, teenage years, and it's been closer to a decade since I've tried it, and I thought it'd make me funny again. And if it's all right with you guys, I'd like to read you the set I wrote the night I was stoned.
This is the last one.
Just kidding. It was like a couple weeks ago. All right, so for some reason it's in quotations. And it says, "Hey guys, what's up?" Then it says, "LOL." Then it says, "So like dicks and farts, am I right?" LOL again. And then there's the eggplant emoji. There's the smiley face with the doctor's mask on. And that's all I wrote. Worked out great. But no, I realized, I think, that night that I don't need to smoke weed to be funny. I like to think of myself as like a smart guy, or at least clever. I can write some jokes. I can't be that stupid. I mean, there's people in 2017 right now who think the fucking earth is flat again. And I don't know where to start with these idiots. Just makes me think, like, maybe Hitler was onto something. And he's just got the type of person wrong, you know? It's not the Jews. It's those flat earth believing Fast and the Furious watching motherfuckers. Mass genocide. Too much? So speaking of killing everyone, I think I'm smarter than. It's a perfect segue into the joke I wrote about pooping your pants. Jesus. Let me elaborate. So I'm not a religious guy by any means. Even growing up, 9, 10 years old, my parents are Christian. I remember going to church and just not really feeling it. I, however, do vividly remember the hardest I prayed at that age was when I had to poop really bad and I was far away from a toilet. Right? And it's tricky, right? Because if you ever end up in that scenario, you gotta walk like fast, but you can't walk too fast because then you lose focus on the clench and you poop your pants. Can't do that. But if you walk too slow, obviously race against the clock, poop your pants. I remember, I literally just like, please Jesus, just let me make it. I'll live a good life. I'll never sin again. Just let me. And boom, you make it, right? You know, 9 times out of 10. And afterwards, you're like, I didn't need Jesus for that. You're just all arrogant about it. I don't need you. Look for sins to commit. You're just so confident. Like, I just went out and committed adultery, you know. Because when I was 10, I was married. Cheating on my wife. That joke needs some help. But I knew I'd be okay doing stand-up because, if you can't tell by looking at me, I'm a battle rapper. For those of you who don't know what that is, I just go to like more urban areas and I just yell insults at black people. Not all my opponents are black, I'm just playing my demographic. So, but the first thing that happens when I tell people I'm a battle rapper, 90% of the time they're like, "Oh, so you're like Eminem?" No, I'm not. Okay? Eminem hasn't rap battled since 1997. And it's one thing if you compare me to Eminem, if you've heard me rap, that's an honor. That's only happened a couple times. But if you haven't heard me rap, and that's the first thing you say, just know, I fucking hate you. It's annoying as shit. Everybody does it. You're an unoriginal, uncultured piece of shit. So the last guy I did it to me, I messed with him a little bit. I was like, "What do you do, sir?" He's like, "I do landscaping and specialize in cutting down trees." I was like, "Oh, cool, you're modern lumberjack. You're like George Washington." Yeah, he didn't think it was that funny either. Another reason I thought I'd be okay with it is because I have thoughts at breakfast like, I wonder what a hooker's W-2 would look like if they had to fill one out.
Yes.
And I'm alone at breakfast. So, yeah, I thought about that. Can you keep it down in the back, please? Thank you. escort. I'm talking like a has a black eye, could be a man, 7-inch stiletto, street whore. Like, what does her W-2 look like if she had to fill it out, right? Like, does she have to specify by job? Hand job, blow job, rim job? And does she have to claim when she pays the pimp? Or is the pimp a dependent? I thought about that. So, I thought I was like, it's they're a small business. It's $10.99, 28% tax. So one of the biggest questions I have is, how much do they get to charge the IRS for fucking them that hard at the end of every year? It's rude. Most of them are classy. Another reason I thought I'd be okay doing stand-up is I have conversations with my idiot friends at bars, and that's enough for material. Like, I have was out with a female friend who's a female bartender I know really well. And the girl leans over to me, she's like, I just got a dick pic. I was like, Jesus. And the bartender immediately chimes in. She's like, why do guys think that's okay? Dicks are ugly. And I was immediately offended. Like, first of all, my dick is gorgeous. If you ever get close enough to see it, it's real pretty. So then I asked them, like, what do you guys send them back? Do you send, you know, what I call twat shots back?
Twat shots.
And they both said yes, like, immediately. I was like, jeez. Because it's, like, think about it. I've seen girls take 10, 20, 30 minutes just to take a picture of their face. Doing their makeup, you know, getting the lighting right. And so imagine the effort it would take to do that and be able to send it to someone confidently. You know, it's, you gotta get the lighting right. And, you know, selfie sticks make a lot more sense now. And I said that to the bartender, she goes, yeah, sometimes you get shadows in the wrong places. I was like, what if you accidentally sent that to the guy? He's looking at me, he's like, is that the well the girl in the ring was trapped in? And I feel like Snapchat promotes this kind of behavior. For some of you, Snapchat is an app where you send things to other people, and there's little filters on them and that kind of thing. There's like seasonal ones. And that's what I use it for. Other people, you know, they think it's safe. The pictures disappear, you know? So they're like, they can just send whatever they want. And then I started thinking about it, and was like, well, if I can make my dick look like Santa Claus, I'm sending that to everyone. Every holiday, you're gonna get that. So, add me on Snapchat, 410, and that's my time. Thank you guys very much.